Let's perform a frontier orbital analysis on this 1-5 sigmatropic rearrangement. First, let's convince ourselves that the order is 1-5. We can see that it's this carbon-hydrogen bond that undergoes migration, and it moves to the position that's highlighted there in the product. Numbering the two terminal positions on the opposite side of the bond that migrates, we'll put a 1 prime on hydrogen and a 1 on this carbon. We'll continue numbering the carbon system until we get to the other position. It's a 5. And we recognize that at hydrogen, this 1 prime atom doesn't have any further connectivity, and so it's a 1 prime over here in the product. The order of the reaction is a 1-5 sigmatropic rearrangement. Recognizing that it's the bond here that breaks, this carbon-hydrogen sigma bond, and thinking about the way we did the analysis for the electrocyclic ring opening reaction, we can imagine that the frontier orbitals that we want to use would be the sigma star on this carbon-hydrogen bond. The filled orbital is going to be the pi system of butadiene. And at this boundary, where the new pi bond forms, we want to match the phases just like we did in the electrocyclic ring closure analysis. And so if we label the phases in the LUMO according to the way they're here with the unshaded large lobe on the back side of the carbon, then we should have a lobe that's shaded and small in between the nuclei of the carbon and the hydrogen. And since hydrogen brings its 1s orbital to this bonding interaction, it's going to be an unshaded lobe centered on the backside of hydrogen that will make the rest of this sigma star orbital. Now, to match the phases between the HOMO-LUMO boundary, we need to match the phase of this lobe on the butadiene HOMO to that of the unshaded phase of the LUMO. That's going to give us a pi-type interaction that's going to show up in the product. It's this part of the molecule here where that new pi bond is going to form. So now we've set the phase between those two, and because we're dealing with the HOMO of butadiene, that fixes the phases everywhere else in the rest of the molecule. The two terminal atoms are phased the same. In butadiene HOMO, there's a node between those two atoms, and so the phases switch between the center two carbons. That means we need to have an unshaded lobe here and an unshaded lobe there. Now, in bringing the molecule together to undergo this 1-5 sigmatropic rearrangement, what we're going to do is match the phases on the backside of that hydrogen with the orbital that is centered at the end of the atom where the bond, the new sigma bond, forms. That's the new carbon-hydrogen sigma bond. By matching the phases, you can see that the lobe above the plane of the pi system is perfectly matched to the phase of the LUMO that was defined by our dissection of this molecule into HOMO and LUMO domains and matching the phase at the boundary. As a consequence, the hydrogen transfers above the plane to a position above the plane in the product. That's going to become very evident in the experiment that's shown on the next slide. What this experiment shows is that the 1-5 sigmatropic rearrangement is a stereospecific reaction, and the stereospecificity follows exactly from the frontier orbital analysis, where we saw that the hydrogen atom left one face and entered the same face of the pi system. Here's how this was demonstrated, starting with this stereo well-defined reactant, in which the configuration at this stereo center is the S configuration, and the double bond geometry with this deuterium atom at the terminal position has the E double bond geometry. Following the 1-5 shift, the hydrogen atom moves over to the carbon that has deuterium, creating a new stereo center since there are four different substituents, but now its stereochemistry is the R configuration. The only way that it would have the R configuration is if that hydrogen atom passed over to the same face, the top face, when this ethyl group is going to result in this double bond geometry here, the E double bond geometry. And so this experiment proved that the hydrogen atom leaves the face and enters the same face in the 1-5 sigmatropic rearrangement. Another prediction from the frontier molecular orbital analysis is that not all combinations are allowed. For example, the 1-3 sigmatropic rearrangement is a disallowed reaction. if you set up the sigma star as LUMO, matching the boundary between the HOMO and the LUMO domains so that there's a developing pi-type interaction, and use the HOMO of ethylene, you'll notice that the lobe on the hydrogen atom must enter the opposite face on the pi system. While that's formally an allowed process, it's impossible for this hydrogen atom to reach around and have any kind of significant overlap. As a consequence of that, this is not an observed reaction. In the next webcast, we'll examine the 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement.